Venus has historically been known as Earth's sister planet. This despite the fact that Venus has an atmosphere that is hostile and incredibly toxic to life that has evolved on our planet. The reason that the planet was granted sister status is because scientists think that Venus may have once been very similar to Earth. It's believed that Venus once possessed a considerable amount of water on its surface, which it has lost over time. The presence of water suggesting that life could have once thrived on the alien world. Scientists have put forward theories which have suggested that Venus ended up the way it has because of runaway greenhouse effect. This on a level way worse than anything we have yet to deal with here on our planet. These greenhouse gases ended up causing Venus to lose its water and turn its atmosphere into something inhospitable to human life. So what life could have and may still call the planet home? Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history and mystery. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss a video again. Recent studies have shown that Venus was, at one time, a planet rich with H2O and may have been capable of supporting a variety of life, not only basic life, but possibly highly evolved intelligent life, something that would be comparable to humanity. This has led many ufologists to ponder the idea that perhaps Venus was once home to human-like species, or if some Venusians managed to survive the cataclysm caused by the greenhouse gases and went on to evolve into a new breed of intelligent beings. Or maybe simpler life forms became more complex. To quote a famous movie, "Life finds a way." The idea of intelligent life existing on other worlds so close to Earth is very exciting to alien theorists. And it's a theory that the group UFO Kokala thinks is true. To have a look at this group and their beliefs about being visited by aliens from Venus, click the link above. So let's look a little more closely at this alien world. Imagine, if you will, a mostly dead planet, a heavy, toxic atmosphere, 90 times thicker than that found on our homeworld, a surface with temperatures that reach up to and above 864 degrees, this being hot enough to melt lead. If we step back 3 billion years ago, things might have been different. The study that was carried out by scientists at NASA's Goddard Institute for Space Studies in New York used computer modeling that has been utilized to predict future climate change here on Earth and applied it to Venus. This in the hopes of revealing what the young planet was like. What they discovered made Venus seem a friendlier place and more like our own planet. The scientists think that it is highly likely that Venus had a shallow ocean along with hospitable surface temperatures, albeit slightly cooler than Earth's. This for as long as 2 billion years of its early history. There were thought to be large clouds that would have created overcast days that would also have shielded the surface from the heat and radiation. Little is known about the oceans of Venus, which were first suggested by NASA's Pioneer missions in the 1980s. But given the planet's placement as the second planet from the Sun, Venus wasn't conducive to sustaining vast oceans like here on planet Earth. Venus receives much more sunlight than we do. This would, and indeed did, evaporate liquid water. This evaporation sending hydrogen up into space and trapping a buildup of carbon dioxide. This is what would lead to the non-stop greenhouse effect on the planet that would create its current toxic atmosphere. The topography of Venus was also completely altered by multiple massive volcanic eruptions that most likely filled in lowland regions and potential ocean basins over the past billion years, this hiding much of the planet's history. Because of this, past research to model the planet would simply place a duplicate of Earth and its topography in Venus's orbit. But a team of researchers, including lead study author Michael Way of NASA, wanted to create the first 3D model of the planet using the correct and current topography. Even if it isn't entirely accurate for the time period that they were modeling, it's the least wrong choice you can make, Way said. So, was there life on Venus? With this model, early Venus sounds a rather cozy place. So could the idea that it supported life be true? Water does not necessarily equal life, Way stressed. What we believe is that water is conducive to life. Mars is a much tougher place for life to have started. It was only warm and wet very early in its history. It's been a mostly dead planet for the last 4 billion years. But the modeling that was done for Venus showed that it might be a better place to look for the beginnings of life. This combination of factors all point to another planet that was capable of supporting life long before Earth. But what about today? Many have made claim that when the planet was a suitable place for life to evolve, it did, and that intelligent life did exist, and today possibly still calls Venus home. So what evidence do we have for this? Well, there are a number of videos that are claiming to show structures on Venus. There has been some manipulation to the images of the Venetian structures. They were converted into computer renderings in an attempt to give them more clarity. The video and images were said to have been recorded and captured by the Magellan probe. Few people care to look for structures in these images, but it is claimed that in fact it is easier to find them on Venus than the many which are said to be spotted on the maps and renderings of the moon's surface. The Magellan probe sent to Venus operated during the late 80s and 90s. It collected an enormous catalogue of images that have finally been published by NASA, in which huge cities and artificial structures and all kinds of elements that seem to be pointing to an intelligent life form inhabiting or maybe colonizing the second planet in our solar system. There are links available online, as well as videos of the locations with suspiciously artificial elements. Today, there is still much debate and speculation over what could be on the planet. Officially, NASA did comment. The space agency headed up and backed an international study which summarizes that there could be simple but sturdy bacteria floating in the uppermost clouds of Venus. David J. Smith of NASA's Ames Research Center said that living terrestrial bacteria have been discovered at high altitudes in Earth's atmosphere. Other microorganisms survive and even thrive in Yellowstone's sulfuric hot springs, hypothermal vents, and at the bottom of the sea. Highly polluted regions and acidic lakes also host life. So with the recent reports by the US Navy, which finally came clean, admitting that indeed UFOs are regularly seen and that the military and government supposedly does not know where they are coming from, what they are, and who could be piloting them. Could these statements on microbes and bacterial life be the first tentative steps to these groups telling the public that alien life is out there? It does make sense and follows the normal government procedure of slowly disseminating information. Are we finally on a path to full disclosure? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. This is the last video of September, so in the next video, I'm thinking about running another giveaway. So make sure, if you're new to the channel, you click that red button and maybe give me a like and a share. Many thanks to all of my old subscribers. Your help and support is greatly appreciated. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you next time.